The first Sunday of Advent was hope. The second Sunday of Advent is peace.
They both were, that was a plus.
Peace. We will love life and see good days if we turn from evil and do good, and if we seek peace, for the Lord watches over the righteous and hears their prayers. Even as we enjoy the gift of the season, so too we can experience its frustrations. Traffic, long lines, depleted store shelves, overloaded schedules, and even family disharmony. Where does the peace of the season go when usurped by these unwelcome happenings? How can we live so that peace is happening from within? A key to peaceful living is to practice forgiveness as a way of living the truth we know. When we forgive, we are choosing to see beyond circumstances, beyond appearances, beyond our immediate reactions. Through forgiveness, we realize that peace comes from releasing resentments, blame, and frustration, and committing to see the truth in ourselves and others. Claiming this peace and living from it is a gift, and not just a gift for one person. It's a gift for everyone. When peace is our natural state, we bless every person, every relationship, every interaction. So no matter how small or fleeting, with our peaceful presence, we grant peace. Let us pray. Dear Lord, the hope we have in Jesus brings joy into our heart. And we know the love of God, His peace will impart. Lord, if we are looking for hope, peace, joy, and love this Christmas season, all we need do is look to God. Amen.
Amen.
Our Old Testament reading is taken from Isaiah chapter 40, verses 3 through 5. A voice of one calling, in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the wilderness a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain and hill made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places a plain. And the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all mankind together will see it. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. The word of the Lord.
If you don't remember what our word of the day is, what is it, Jason?
Peace.
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 Our gospel lesson this morning comes from Luke chapter 1, beginning with verse 26. Listen as we begin to hear more of Mary's story. In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be barren is in her sixth month, for nothing is impossible with God. I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May it be to me as you have said. Then the angel left her. May God bless us with the reading of these words this morning. This brings us 2 weeks till Christmas. You should all be saying yay. Yikes. We started out with hope. And this week is peace. In today's world, I'm not sure that we really know what peace is. Even when we have what I call normal days, and that's normal, what's normal for you is not normal for me. But when we have normal days, they are not always peaceful, are they? No. The world around us is so, so loud. When things get quiet in my house, it's actually a little odd. I have to remind you that I live at a corner of a traffic light. I'm so used to the noise of the day between just daily traffic, kids and their parents walking up to science school, people waiting for the bus and talking oh so softly on their cell phones, police, ambulances, fire trucks. Well, it's really quite chaotic at times. Horns blare at all times, and yes, I even hear choice words when others' frustrations boil over because of traffic. It is not peaceful in the world around us. And I have a feeling that things are not about to change in our future. So how is it that we can find peace? What I have discovered is that our definitions of peace are all different. When I think of peace, I think of peace and quiet. For me, they must go together. For me, the sound of the ocean is peaceful. It brings tranquility to my soul. It helps me relax. It helps me to be at peace. You see, it is not peace itself, but it takes me to a peace. It brings me to a feeling of peace. So what is peace? Peace, I think, is a state of mind. It's not dependent on our surroundings, since we already determined that we live in a noisy world. In our scripture this morning, Mary received some pretty upsetting news. Here she was, a young woman without a husband, yet betrothed to Joseph. And Gabriel tells her that she's going to have a baby. Let me tell you, that would not have been good news. But in the chaos of that moment, after Gabriel gives her some more details, Mary finds peace. We need to look to Mary to see where we can find peace in the chaos that life brings. I'm convinced that peace is not of this world. Peace is only a product and a gift from God. God gives us that peace that passes understanding. Just look to Scripture to see how many times peace is mentioned. In all kinds of circumstances, the peace of God can be found. That's where we make our mistakes. We look for peace we look to the world around us to find peace, but true peace can only come through God. Remember, Jesus was called the Prince of Peace. Knowing Jesus is the key to experiencing that peace, learning to lean on Him, knowing Him, learning to trust in Him, trying to meditate on His words is what can bring us peace. But there's more. If we stay grounded in the confines of this world, we will never find peace in our hearts, for peace is not a product of our world. When we are faced with life challenges, and yes, they are different for all of us, having faith in Christ is sometimes the only thing that can bring us peace. Our faith doesn't protect us from ever experiencing tough times, does it? No. We've all been there. It doesn't protect us from heartache, from suffering, from loss and disappointment. It doesn't protect us from struggles, but it gives us a way to walk through those times, knowing that God is indeed by our side. We too can be in the midst of chaos, yet our minds and our very souls can be at peace, thanks to the presence of our Savior. That's what happened to Mary. When she had the visit from Gabriel, God knew how she would react, or he would have not chosen her for the task of bringing the Christ child into the world. Ladies, put yourself in Mary's sandals. Would your reaction have been the same? Let's be honest. Not many of us would be up for that challenge. I know I wouldn't have been, and I can be honest about it. The lesson we need to learn today is peace does not come from the world. It only comes from God. We can attempt to position ourselves in situations that are peaceful, situations that are serene, or quiet, or beautiful. But unless our God is present, we will never experience peace. That to me means that peace can be found anywhere, as long as we open our hearts and our minds to the presence of the Prince of Peace. So in this season of chaos, make sure the Prince of Peace has a reserved space in your everyday. Whether it be in prayer and meditation, in reading or studying the scriptures, or in listening to God and following his direction, you will find peace, the peace that passes all understanding. Let us live in the hope of Advent and look forward to the peace that only God can give. Amen. This week, I want you to look for peace. See if you can find peace around you, and maybe you'll realize that peace can only be found within us. Look to our Lord Jesus Christ for that perfect peace. Savor it and live in that moment this week, giving him the thanks for the hope and the peace that only he can give. Amen.